With the idea for Goat Fest.
I'm going to have to blame Dale Opperman on that one.
What did Dale say?
He wants to put he started to put goats on the island 3 years ago. We've been maintaining the goats ever since then, and we decided to do a little fundraiser to help with that cause. Maybe even build a bridge someday tonight.
We have the three goats that are out on the island down there. That's Buddy and Elsa. So come and meet them and greet them, pet them, feed them. We also have an extra goat over there.
That's Andy
Tapsco. So who brought this all together?
I would say Friends of Goat Island. A bunch of people got together at a event a couple times and put it together. It seems to be working out very well.
We got bird houses that you can help a homeless birdie if you want. So if you build a bird house for $5, you can donate it back and we'll put it out on the island for you. Go see it if you paddle out there.
And what are some of the other things that are happening today?
We have goat yoga happening at 3 o'clock. At 3:30, we're going to have a goat race to see which one of the three goats makes it across the Rocky Bridge. And we'll donate half the money back, so that's a kind of a raffle that's going on. We have coloring for the kids that you can do. We can also buy a t-shirt. The kids' t-shirts are white, and they can color their t-shirts if they would like.
Can you turn around so I can see the back of the shirt? We're goating outside. Is it true that this was going to be called Goat Meat Lookout Days?
That discussion was had, yes. Decided to maybe do that next year.
All right, thank you.
Muchas gracias. Just showing off my bilingual skills here. Dankeschön, Dankeschön.
Hey, you know, we got free hot dogs for the first 100 kids that requested Say Please up at the concession stand. Those are sponsored by the Friends of Goat Island, so if your kiddos haven't had a hot dog yet, please go up there. We also have delicious, I'm talking award-winning, smoked barbecued pulled pork from Jerry Hofferman, and he and his crew, Becky and Jerry and their whole family are terrific barbecuers, and they are award-winning, and we have it here today for the price of $7 for a plate. You can get a nice sandwich and some chips and a side. So no excuse to go hungry here today. We also have the Lions serving beverages back there. Go see Jim Warren. And we have Lewis Station Winery with their wine cocktails, and wine slushies. And what would be better than that on a beautiful summer day? That's my commercial. Back to the band. This is just kind of like the Saturday night.
I'm kind of hungry. How old you got to be for that hustle?
That Grand Ole Opry. If you bring your dad, you're considered a kid. Sorry. There's no goat is served today. No, goats are our friends. This is a goat-free event from the menu.
That's good. All right, you're great.
This happened once before when I came to your door. There we tried. They said it wasn't you, but I saw you peek through in your window. I saw the light. Tried to telephone, they said you were not home. That's a lie. Cause I know where you've been. I saw you walk in your door. I nearly died. I nearly died. Cause you walked hand in hand with another man.
Thank you so much. We are the Van Eskies. We are probably going to be changing our name shortly to the Corey and the Old Fogies. And
Corey and the Coots.
F-O-G-I-S. It's Friends of Goat Island. So Corey's the little guy on the drums back here, the youngest member of the band.
He's a pirate.
He's the youngest member. He's 57. That would make me 98. Oh, here we go. This is a song about, a very sad song about love that was lost at the Walmart parking lot. I said, I'm just going in for a six pack, honey.
Got my pajama pants on.
Yes, and when I came back, she was gone.
Go eat the beer.
Just an hour before, now I'm staring at the bodies just to dance across the floor, and then the band sold the temple and the music's up and down, it was the same old song in melancholy town, so strange on new atmospheres, and then the jukebox plays a song I used to know, now I'm staring at the bodies just dancing so slow, cause it's so easy to say that you forget your past. They don't ride them like that anymore. No, they just don't ride them like that anymore. They just don't ride them like that anymore. No, they just don't.
gotta do. I'm gonna ask you all to help me out here. We're gonna sing happy birthday to my first little grandson, Lane James Sir, over there in the stroller. I wave at him and he thinks, is that Grandpa? What's going on there? He's the cute little guy there. That's him. That's him. He's two today. I wish I was two again. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Oh, no, nice red, white, and blue pants. I love it. Happy birthday, little Wayne James. Happy birthday to you.
Isn't it cute?
True whiskey headed right for the stage.
Right? Luckily, yep.
Give me that microphone.
You want to come up here and give Grandpa a kiss? That would be cool. I mean, that would really be cool, don't you think? If I got a kiss from my little guy?
Hey, play that Baby Shark song. You know he's going to walk on every gig you ever do from now on.
Yeah, well, God blessed us. He looks nothing like Grandpa. Yes, he's a cute little dude. He can count up to 10, and he knows all his colors. He's way smarter than I am. He says, oh, I want to go back up there now. Here we go.
What's up, boys?
The electric guitar. Little thing called... Ain't That a Shine? It's not a country song, although it should be, you know, it should be like, Ain't That a Shine? Okay, here we go.
Hey guys,
She's so good. I'm not touching you. Audrey, which one's your favorite one? Elsa?
A little bit of grass that had a lot of water. I got that layer. That was fast.
Just showing off my bilingual skills here.
What's the show?